Australia should become a republic by the year 2001.
If we are to become a republic, then the people themselves should directly choose the president.
We are all Australians. We share a continent. We share a past, a present and a future. And our head of state should be one of us.
I commit the coalition that if it wins office at the next election, it will have a people's convention. And if a consensus for change emerges from that convention, the coalition will put that consensus to the Australian public at a referendum.
Our common bond is Australia's future.
There must be a sense of excitement amongst here today.
This is the vote. This is the vote to tell the Prime Minister that Republicans want a republic and give our people something to vote on. It's only taken 100 years to get this far. Who knows when we'll get another crack?
Now, the only common sense interpretation of this convention is, firstly, that a majority of people have voted generically in favour of a republic, and secondly, that amongst the republican models, the one that has just got 73 votes is clearly preferred. Now, when you bind those two together, it would be a travesty in common sense terms of Australian democracy for that proposition not to be put to the Australian people.
Republicans applauding John Howard. Savour the moment. Through all of its twists and turns, the convention finally delivered a result. Australians will now decide the issue at a referendum.
While I don't support the proposition, I do congratulate the Republicans on their victory, and even I felt a slight lump in the throat when I saw your jubilation and the jubilation of people in the gallery when you had the numbers, and I congratulate you and I wish you well.
It's 7 a.m. at Sydney's Circular Quay, and Malcolm Turnbull is making a last-minute bid to win over swinging voters.
The referendum, sir.
He's given 10 years and a small part of his personal fortune to make Australia a republic.
Good on you. Voted the right way too.
But right now, he can see his dream evaporate.
This has been a very, very deceitful campaign from the other side. They've been saying vote.
Look, the proudest thing I've ever done in my life is help to give Australians the opportunity to have one of their own citizens, one of us, an Australian, as our head of state.
The No campaign has said if you want a different kind of republic, if you want to elect the president, vote no. It's become very clear. You've only got to read the papers this morning to see what John Howard has in mind. If Australia votes no, that's it.
Well, look, Malcolm, that's just completely wrong. No means no to this fundamentally flawed republic.
Well, did the Prime Minister rule out a plebiscite this morning or not? Did he?
James's concern is understandable. If her side wins tomorrow, it will do so riding on the back of radical Republicans like Ted Mack, who want a president elected by the people.
I'm quite sure this is not the end, because two-thirds of Australia want to become a republic. It certainly won't go away. It is now a major political issue.
Most prime ministers in the past, if they haven't supported something, they haven't put it up. But I've recognised a desire on the part of the Australian people before the turn of the century to have a vote on this issue. And even though I'm personally against it, I put it up. As Tom Keneally said at the Constitutional Convention, it was the ultimate act of grace on my part being opposed to a republic.
I voted no. I want to have a say in who they elect, that's all.
Yes, I voted yes. I voted for a republic and to change the preamble. We're Australian and we can make decisions on our own. We don't need to hold the hand of the Queen anymore. No, on both issues, yeah.
No, we wouldn't be able to make the decision in the long run.
This was the best republic that the best brains of the republican movement could come up with. And it could only get 45% support. And that is a credit to the healthy scepticism of the Australian people when faced with change for change's sake and a dud model republic.
Regroup and in 2 or 3 years' time come back with a program of activities which I think ultimately could lead to an Australian head of state within 7 to 10 years.